The top brass of the New South Wales Police Force is tonight being accused of covering up the tasering of 95-year-old great-grandmother Clare Nowland. Documents gained under Freedom of Information laws reveal an initial police media release was rewritten before it was released, taking out key details.
The police tasering of 95-year-old Clare Nowland was destined to make headlines, and now the New South Wales police hierarchy stands accused of trying to play it down.
It's come to light that there has been a cover-up.
The Sydney Morning Herald has revealed on May 17, 6 hours after the incident, police drafted a media release stating the grandmother was armed with a knife. And when she stood up and moved towards officers, a taser was deployed by a constable. The release was later reviewed and redone. More than half the statement had been slashed to remove any mention of the tasering, instead calling it an interaction. In an interview with Nine News 5 days after the incident, the police commissioner admitted signing off on the final draft.
There was no mention of taser. Was this a cover-up?
No, not at all.
In Parliament, the police minister admitted she was unaware the initial police release had been redone.
It was the first I'd heard of an earlier, more detailed draft when I mentioned that in my response.
Exhibit one, the police minister, missing in action yet again. How on earth could she not have known?
The police commissioner from the beginning has insisted that the use of the taser was left out of the statement so as police could contact all family members first. But just 8 days after the critical incident involving Clare Nowland in Chatswood, a man was shot dead by police. An hour and 15 minutes after the shooting, a release went out explaining what happened.
I think it's an extraordinary claim for the member for Wurrunga to suggest there's been a cover-up.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.